Hi everyone, welcome to Rose Hip Knits podcast episode 41. My name is Hannah and I am recording this podcast from Northern Tasmania in Australia. This is a podcast mainly about what I have been knitting, but also about some other crafty things I have been up to, a little bit about my hand dyeing and a little bit of show and tell of what I have in my Etsy shop. You can find me as Rose Hip Chick on Instagram and on Ravelry. There is a group for this podcast that you can find by searching for Rose Hip Knits Podcast. And today I would just like to say thank you to everybody for taking time and watching. I have a couple of more thank yous later on in this episode because I have received some mail and there were some giveaways and cows that I won, so I'd like to show them later on and say thank you. But today I'd like to get straight into some knitting because I don't want this episode to go on for too long before I get into some of the stuff that's actually interesting and the stuff that I'm here to talk about. So I have some knitting to share with you. I have a few things that I've finished. I have a finished thing that I can't find and I have been searching all morning. But I gave up, so I'll have to insert a photo. So I have knitting, I finished. I have some knitting that I'm working on. I have some things that arrived, like I said, that I'd like to show you, just because I'm very happy to have received some prizes. And I'd like to say thank you. And of course, share with you some of the goodies that are out there that you can get hold of. And then I have some dyeing to share with you. So we do that later on. So let's get on with some knitting. For a while now, I have been knitting on a shawl that I was not able to really show you because it was a test knit and it was secret. But the pattern is now published, so I'm able to show you. You have seen it a little bit before I got into the lace section too much. This is a little princess shawl, a little princess shawl by Sarah, who's yarn poetry on Ravelry. And I knit this in my Princess Lily's colorway, which I thought was very fitting, and I really like this color. The way I did it, and I am a very loose knitter, and that combined with how I blocked this shawl made it really, really, really long. It's almost like a scarf. I really like it. It suits me and how I like to wear my shawls. So it has a stockinette body and then a lace panel and a picot edging. It was really fun to knit. It was a long time, no, it wasn't a long time ago that I needed stockinette body on a shawl, but I've mostly been doing garter. So even though it's not as easy as just knit for a garter section, it gives it a little bit more interest when you do purl as well, I guess, even if it's not always what you feel like doing. So yes, that's the shawl. And I have had it sort of tucked away for a bit since I blocked it and finished it. So it's lost its shape a little bit. But yes, I really like it. I really like this colorway. I have a lot of blue and purple and green shawls and cowls. So yes, purple, green and blue. So it was nice to have a pink one for a bit of a difference. So that's that one. So you can find it on Ravelry and purchase this pattern. I don't think I have a lot more to say about it. We're having a really nice day today. It's really, spring has really started here now. It is overcast today though, so even though it's quite light outside, I'm not sure that the colours are coming out really well. This Princess Lilith colorway has this sort of raspberry pink in all different tones, and then there are also a few little speckles of a purple, but I'm not sure that you can see them. You can see that I have knitted this very, very loose, but it's very nice and drapey. And this is in my Oss sock base, which is a Australian merino nylon, and it's really, really soft. So that was that one that I was now able to share with you. So I'd like to say thank you to Sarah for letting me test knit that. I really enjoyed it. And then after I finished that shawl, I continued working on my Multnomah shawl that I started quite a while back. I can't remember when it was. I think I showed you this last time. Did I? I'm just going to quickly check. Yes, I did show you that I was working on it last time. I knit this in my Tasmanian Ethical Superfine Merino base, which is the white gum wool base that is a Tasmanian wool, like I said. So I started maybe in April, and I got that finished. Oh yes, now I remember. It's been so long since I did a recording. We've all been unwell. This winter has just been terrible for colds and coughs and things. So we've had probably about a month that at least one of us in the family has been unwell. And it was my turn last week, and it was not good. Sorry. But I'm all better now. And but yes, I think it's been a while since I recorded, because I was just not able to for a while. But what has happened since last time I recorded is that Stash Dash finished. So the last thing that I did for Stash Dash was finishing this Multnomah shawl. So I finished that feather and fan part of it. Let's see if I show you. Oh, I'll show you the right way. And this is lovely and soft. This is a colorway that I think I called Delilah. It has pinks, purples, grays, a little bit of yellow in it. And I really like it. A lot of these shawls that I have done recently using my own yarn bases and hand dyed, I think I'll keep them for samples. Not that I think that I will be going to any fibre events or markets or anything. There's just not really anything around in my area that I think would be worthwhile going to. But I still think it's nice to have knitted samples of your yarn bases and some of your colourways. So I thought I'll have this for that. I do also have my veranda shawl though that I did in the same base, so yeah. Of course I'll still wear them, but I'll make sure I'll keep them nice and clean. So that's one, that one. I really enjoy this pattern. So I finished that, and then I did finish the socks that I made out of my self-striping in the Perth colourway, and they are the thing that I cannot find. I thought I put them out here in my studio ready to show you, but I cannot find them here, and I cannot find them inside where I have my knitting stuff. I vaguely remember my little girl trying them on and playing with them. So maybe they disappeared after that. I'm not sure. Or maybe they're in a project bag somewhere. But I have a photo of them, and I posted a photo on Instagram. I'll just reach over. So what I did, and I told you last time, I did the short row heel that Lara Neal has in this book, the sock architecture book. And then when I was doing the toe, I thought, oh, I'll try a different toe as well. So I did the sideways toe, which means that you do, normally when you do a toe, you do the decreases on the sides of your toes or your foot, But with the sideways, was it a sideways wedge toe? Well, anyway, you do the decreases on the top of the foot and the bottom of the foot. So it looks sort of like your toe is twisted. But I tried that and that worked really well. And I really like those socks. It was funny because the colors of the socks were not something that I would pick up and like, and wouldn't choose that those colors myself to knit socks in. As you know, everything I do is purple, blue, and pink, green sometimes. But the white, black, and red, it's just not something that I'd gravitate to. But I suspected that there was one part in this skein that was misdyed, so I just decided that I was going to knit that myself. And I'm really happy that I did, because I did really, really enjoy it. And it's good sometimes just use completely different colors. And that's also one thing that I really enjoy with hand dyeing, and not only hand dyeing for myself, but hand dyeing for my online Etsy shop, is that I don't only think about what do I like to use, what are my colors that I like. I also experiment with other colors that I normally would not do for myself, because I'm trying to make my stock appeal to all people that have different color preferences. So anyway, I enjoy them, and I'm so sorry that I can't find them and I can't show you. I have to find them because I want to have my socks. Anyway, one more thing actually that I finished, that I both started and finished just on the weekend, actually just a couple of days ago. And I have them in this beautiful bag that my mum made for me. And I had planned to do this for a long time. If you have watched before, quite a while ago, I made a few hats, beanies, a while back. And I think it was when Stash and Burn had like a hat knit along. Or I think it was like 15 hats in 2015. Something like that. I didn't knit a lot of hats from Stash Yarn. I did a bankhead hat out of some Yosharp wool. And I tested I think it's called a Helix hat by Holly Dapp. Oh, I still haven't woven in the end. Or I have, but I haven't cut it off. And I did this in my own hand-dyed DK superwash. I really like it. And this one, it's sort of grey variegated, but it has bits of tealy blues in it, some speckles here and there. And this colourway is sort of a tealy greeny blue. And I had leftovers of both of those, and I thought I'll do some fingerless mitts or something. And so there's leftovers, and I've had these in this project bag with the beanies for a long time. And finally, I decided to make some camp out mitts, camp out fingerless mitts, which are these ones. I haven't made this pattern before with the Noro yarn. I can't remember which one. An Erin Waite one. So in the pattern they used the same yarn for the whole thing, but what I did was that I did this band, which is a free pattern, and I really recommend it. It's really good. It's really easy. You need one of these mitts in not long at all. So I did these two on the weekend. Anyway, this is 10 stitches that you just knit in a strip and graft them together with a 3-needle bind off. So you have the tube, and then you pick up stitches around here. You do the cast on some stitches for the thumb and decrease here while you knit down, and then you just knit a tube. I'm sorry, that was probably not very good explained, very well explained, sorry. But yes, I did those and I really, really like them. The other ones that I made, I've gave away as presents, which was really good. Good thing to have. So I thought, I still have leftovers. These take, I think, less than 30 grams for the pair. So I still have more, and I think I might make a couple more just to have in my gift basket. Not sure. But now I have these to match both of those hats. And the reason that I looked at the camp out mitts was actually because I was looking something to do for the Canada Cow that I think it's a Grocery Girls podcast that has the Canada Cow. So I wanted to find a pattern by a Canadian designer, and I think it's Tante M on Ravelry that is the designer. I think she is TMA. Is her Ravelry name just TMA? And she's in Canada. So I thought they'd go with the Canada Cow, and they're perfect for what I wanted to do to go with my hats. So they are the things that I have finished. So I'm also working on a few things, of course. One thing that I have shown you recently is my Moonraker shawl. This is a pattern by Melanie Berg. That's what it looks like. I won this pattern, or Skein and Abel podcast had a, they had both a cow and a giveaway, and I got a prize in each of them, but I can't remember what this was the prize for, but it was a pattern of your choice, and this was the pattern that I chose for my prize. And I have been working on it for a while, because I started on it and then I put it down for a while because I was traveling and other things. What I had decided to use was this purple for one of the main colors. And this is a Dale Baby Ool from Dale of Norway, I think they're called. So it's a Norwegian one. So I'm using that for my first main color. And then this variegated lighter purple is a merino nylon cashmere from Flock and Needle, which is an Australian indie dyer. Do I have the label? No. Anyway, it's a bit of a mess in the bag. So that's that one that you start using here for the daisy stitch, and then that's the sort of second main color for the second half of the shawl. And then the green one here is a nettle wool from Onion. I think that's a Danish brand, Onion Knit. So this is a nettle sock yarn that my mum gave me. And then for another one, another colorway, this one here that you use for some of the daisy stitch, I used this little mini skein that Andy of Andre Sunitz sent me a while ago. Yes, so they are the colorways that I have used so far. I'll show you this. It's really quite large at the moment because I have used dark purple. I've almost used all of what I have, and that was 100 grams. And then I have all these daisy stitches in between. So yes, it's rather large. And again, I'm a very loose knitter. I always end up running out of yarn. And I actually did almost run out of this purple again. I was meant to do another section like this before starting on my second main color, but I just had to start it earlier. At first I thought, oh, this is a bit annoying. Should I try to find more of this yarn? And I think I'm just a bit in the mind of test knitting and trying to do everything accurate and according to the pattern. But then I realized that it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You don't have to follow the colors exactly like the pattern and do things in the right order. Really, you just keep knitting it and you can do whatever colors for all of these daisy stitches. So that was nice to realize and to feel the freedom and just go for it. So I've just continued on that. the rows are getting longer and it's taking more and more time to finish a row, but I really, really like it, and I will really enjoy this shawl once it's done and I can wear it. And I'm very happy to work on it again because I have it in my bag from Sandra of Craftfulness on Etsy. And oh, this is such a beautiful bag. I really love it. And I saw that she has some more really nice new things in her shop now. Very tempting. I am working on my Shiago needles, 3.5 millimeters. And I love them too. So just all around really enjoyable thing to have around. Another thing that I have been working on, I just cast it on really not long ago, probably after I did the camp out mitts, a pair of socks that I have in this bag that my mum made again. I just cast on a sock from some commercial sock yarn. I have all my 4-ply fingering weight yarn in a sort of square plastic bag that you get when you buy a doona or a duvet, and sitting on the shelf here, it's like that size, maybe smaller than my warping board there, but I have them in there, and I just needed something that would be easy to cast on my 9-inch circulars, and I didn't have to skein up before or ball up before using it. I just wanted to grab it and start knitting. So this skein of Bendigo Woolen Mill sock yarn was one of the things that I found first, and I could just grab the ball and start knitting a sock. And I had, it's not the most exciting yarn, I'm not overly keen on it, I don't mind it, I don't think it's very exciting to knit on, but it's okay. But I had been curious about what it would look like because I've been tempted to buy more. I know why, I don't, it's just, you know, it's there. I found it in the back room when I was over in Bendigo a while ago, and I thought, oh, maybe I need some more of that. And I thought, no, Hannah, you haven't even touched a ball that you bought online a while ago. So now I thought I really should knit it up and see what it looks like and see if I like it. And now I'm really happy I did, because I do like it, but it's not something that I necessarily want to buy more of. I think there might be, for a present, there might just be one of those I do in a size that I know will fit a few people, and I'll just keep them for when I need a gift. We'll see. I was having a look in the sock architecture book again to see about heels. But I think the only heel in that book that I can do keeping the sock on my 9-inch circulars is the short row heel. So I might do that again. We'll see. I think I've knitted the leg long enough now to do a heel. So I really do need to do the heel so I have the easy knitting again. So I did that. And then my last knitting thing to show you is in this amazing bag from Katie of Knit and Stitch Bits. And this is a project that I started over a year ago and worked on it up until maybe January, maybe February sometime. I do remember I worked on it when my sister was here, and that was January, February. And then I haven't touched it. And this is the Praline cardigan by Gudrun Johnson. That's the one. And I keep saying I'm going to keep working on this. You know, first I said, when it's dash dash, I'll take the opportunity and work on this. It's really good. And then I thought, oh no, I'm just not going to get around to it. So I thought, okay, after I finish all these other projects, I'll knit all my praline cardigan. And now is that time when I need to pick it up again. I'm making it out of some mini duet from Sadness Garn, which is a Norwegian brand. My mum gave this to me last year, July last year. She had bought it to make the deco cardigan, but just wasn't meant to be, and she gave that to me, which was very generous of her. And I started on this praline cardigan, and this pattern was another price for a cowl, and that was for Mando Bug Crafts, Amanda, and that was another price where it was a pattern of your choice, and this was what I chose when I won that cowl, or when I was selected for the giveaway. And this is how much I have. I'm doing this on some hi-hi-us. Oops, it's a bit hard to show you. This is a cardigan, but I have done the pockets, the decreases for the waist shaping, and the increases. So I think I have a little bit longer to go, and then there's the whole sleeve thing and stuff. It's a very nice textured pattern. But it does take a little bit of focus to work on this, and it is fingering weight yarn. It is a merino and cotton blend, so it's not as easy on your hands as just a wool yarn. I think it would be nice once it's done, and I really want to work on it. I love the color. It's really good quality yarn, and the pattern is good, but I'm at the point now where it has this continue for this long and do this and at the same time do this, and it's just been a bit too much for my brain. So I decided to pick this up again and put some effort into it and actually finish it, and I had the additional push of a new cowl starting, and that's the Graveyard Cowl by Katrina of Cat's Kettle or Yarn 30 podcast. And for that knit along, you get old projects out they haven't worked on for over a month, and you either say it's alive and you finish it, or you put it to rest and you frog it and you're done with it. So I think it started 1st of September, I'm pretty sure, and it will go for 2 months, I think. So I really want to finish this in the next couple of months. And I don't really have anything except for the Moonraker shawl, which it's not a complicated shawl. It's an easy knit. I only have that and the socks, and this I will try to keep as my main project and not really start dreaming too much about other things, even though I would like to start working on my other jumpers that I have had planned for a while. But yes, that's what's happening with my knitting. Okay, so we've had a knit along in our group, the double dip dash along, which was basically anything that you finish for Stash Dash by the Knit Girls podcast. You could enter it in one of the finished threads in our podcast group. So we had one thread for spinning and one for knitting and crochet. And I just used random.org just before, because I did it on my phone and that's what I'm recording on. So for the spinning thread to start with, I did write down, there were only 7 people participating, but that's good. And there were 9 projects, and the winner that I drew was post number 3, which is Saratoga Knitting, and this is the prize that Lisa wins. So if you just send me your address, I will be able to post this to you. So that's very exciting. The winning post, number three, was a beautiful skein of some green yarn, and Lisa actually used that to knit a shawl that she posted in the finished knitted item thread. So that was a very well deserved prize, I think. Congratulations. And then for the knitting and crocheting finished thread, there were quite a few entries, over 130 I think, or about 130. And I have a prize that is a pattern from Clothesline Design, which is by Quilt Caroline on Ravelry. And the winner of that was post number 54, which is Stina Bland Barnockgarn, who is in Sweden. And oh yes, Saratoga Knitting, that's a podcast, Knitting by the Sea, I think it's called now. And Bland Barnockgarn is a Swedish podcast on YouTube. So they both have podcasts. But yes, Stina, you can... Oh, I'll just make sure you... well, you just let me know which one of the designs of Clothesline Design that you like. I'll just organise that. And Stina had knit a really cool pair of socks out of some leftover sock yarn. And then the prize, the other prize for that knitting and crochet is this sock blank from Cutiful Yarns, Christina, that I bought as a prize. And the winner of that was post number 89, which was Lime Happy Cat. She knitted a Diane, it is from Melbourne. She knitted a kids cardigan out of DK weight, I think. It was really nice. And yes, send me your postal address, please. I think maybe I have it. I think you have been a customer in my Etsy shop. Anyway, just when you've seen this, please send me your postal address and I will have this sent out to you. So congratulations to everyone, and great job everyone for all the things that you finished in June, July, August. Well done. I ended up making my 3,000 meters so I could enter into Stash Dash, one of the finish lines. I didn't make it to 5,000, but I was happy that I was able to post in one of the finish line threads. I had some stuff arriving in the mail. I have to share that with you. Jinx Yarn, or the Dyer's Notebook podcast, Laura had a dye-along, which is really what inspired the dye-along that I had a while back. I participated in her first one, and she recently had another one, and that's when I dyed up my Ronja Robbersdaughter colourway. And I was lucky enough to be drawn for a prize. And the prize arrived, and it was this beautiful skein from Stranded Dye Works from Great Britain. This is a beautiful grey. It's very shiny yarn. It's 7525 superwash merino nylon in the colourway Magpie. I had not heard about this dye before. And that's what's so much fun with watching podcasts from other places in the world and just finding out about these different indie businesses. And yes, I'm very happy, so thank you. Excellent. I have no idea what to do with it, but I think it will have to be in the two colour shawl, maybe have this and then have a bright one to go with it. We'll see. Okay, the other thing that arrived was my swap package from the Arctic Knitting podcast from Emily. I just have to Yes. And it ended up being a swap, but first it was actually a giveaway that she did. Oh, sorry about all the plastic. It started as a giveaway that Emily did on Instagram, and I was lucky enough to be drawn for, and I won these two Manos del Uruguay skeins. This is Oxygen colorway and this is Patina, and they're extra fine merino and silk. I think they're a DK weight. They're 135 meters on a 50 gram skein, and they are so beautiful. And there's this little project keeper. Gorgeous. Thank you, I feel so lucky again. And then we said, oh, we'll just add a few things. And I sent a nice swap package to Emilia. Emily? It's hard, I'm thinking in English, but it's a Norwegian name. Emily Bjørner? Anyway. Very gorgeous girl who has a very good podcast and does some beautiful dyeing for her Arctic knitting Etsy shop. Anyway, she sent me also this Norwegian sock yarn. It's a single ply sock yarn, Nordlys superwash wool, and it's purples and pinks and blues and greens. That will be fun to try. And then some minis. Of different fun colors and some chocolates. So that was really fun to receive in the mail. Okay, so what I have left now is to share a little bit about what I have been up to with my dyeing and a bit of sewing. For some reason, I was very inspired by Halloween. I must have seen, I think it all started because I found a fabric that was Halloween themed. And I have never really done anything Halloween. In Sweden, when I grew up, we did not celebrate Halloween. It's a different, it's like an All Saints Day when you go and light candles in graveyards, and it's more, has a totally different feel to it. There's no trick or treat or anything like that. It's changed now, and it's the same here in Australia. Sort of the American Halloween tradition has sort of spread a bit. And I think last year was the first year really that we did some sort of Halloween, and that was because my then 5-year-old heard about it and we wanted to do something with her, so we did have a small Halloween celebration then. But anyway, I found this fabric that was Halloween themed, and I will show that to you. Sorry, I put all my stuff a bit too far away. So the fabric that I found was this one. And I'm not really an orange person, but I thought it was very cute. So I bought that a while ago, and I started thinking, oh, I should make some project bags and dye up special Halloween colorway and do some project keepers, process keepers, and just make a little kit for my Etsy shop. Then we got sick and we were away on the weekends in the snow, and time just flew by, and I wasn't really sure when you really need to have the Halloween stuff up and available, or how long before Halloween for it to be sensible. Then I cut out bags, I had that ready, I thought about my colorways, I did dye them up and had things ready, they were drying and things were coming together. Then I thought, by doing kits, it's really limiting things for people, the options, and because all my bags are different and I had the colorway on 4 different bases plus the self-striping, I found it hard to put together kids because they would all be different, and someone might not like the yarn that I put with the bag and they would prefer another one of the bases with that bag. Anyway, it's just, I thought it's easier if customers can choose themselves. If they want to put together a bag and a yarn, they can choose which one they want, or they can just get one or the other. So I just ended up putting a few bags up that are Halloween themed, and then my trick or treat and colorway. So this is what one of the bags looks like. I don't have all of them left, some have sold, so but that's that one. And I did do it in a few different colors of the base. I did get new labels, Rosehip Island labels, that I'm much more happy with than the other ones that I got that I never really used. So these are all a little bit different. They have different ribbons, drawstrings. They all have the same lining, but they're all, again, all different colors here. And this is just my normal size and way that I make them. I think this is a size that I find very useful myself. So I have those. And then the other fabric that I use, that is, I mean, this is just a fabric that would work at any time, but it just sort of, the colors went with the other one. And I only have this one for now. I have some cut out, but I haven't sewn them up yet. So that's that one. But the color. So my special Halloween colorway that I call Trick or Treat, I did it on four yarn bases, as I said, and I've shown you before how different things can look on different yarn bases, and this is one of those cases. I did it on my New Zealand sock, which is what I use for my self-striping, and so you can see that the colorway is a longer section of a gray, shorter green, shorter purple, and orange. So I was thinking of sort of a flashing effect of the bright colors in the darker color. And I did reskein one of each of them. So this is what it looks like reskeined. And on the Oss sock, it looks quite similar. Not quite as bright. The green is not quite as bright, but yes, very similar. But then on the bamboo sock, it looks quite different if you compare it to the New Zealand sock. Unless it's reskeined. It still has bright pops, but the grey is not as dark. And this base just has much more of a shine to it. But it's more of a peachy orange in this one. And then the last one I did was the Tasmanian superfine, ethical superfine, merino nylon, which is my new sock base, and it is much lighter in these. I couldn't get the bright colors, but I think it's just a different way. So it has this sort of peachy pink to purple to green, and then with the gray. And maybe not as doesn't make you think of Halloween maybe as much as the other ones that are a bit brighter, but I still think it's really beautiful on this base. And then in addition to those four, I did a self-striping using the same colors, and I did it on the New Zealand sock base that I use for my self-striping normally. And this is, so it's the same colours, it's the green, purple, orange and grey. This is what it looks like skeined up. So yeah, this is what the Halloween self-striping looks like, which is quite fun. I had fun with those. It was fun to do a themed colorway, try and match it with bags, and then do it on different yarn bases and see how they all look differently or look different. So that was fun. That's all up in the shop, and I mean I've called them Halloween colorways, but or a Halloween colorway, but really they're working around. I think I'm very tempted to knit with one of them. I just can't decide which one I want to knit up. Maybe a sock one, we'll see. And I think if I check my show notes, that probably is what I had to share with you today. I hope that my neighbours have not been too noisy in the background. I hope the light has been okay, and that some things that I talked about today you found interesting. I'm going to continue drinking my tea and do a few things. Thank you to all of you for watching, taking the time, and please be in contact if you have anything you'd like to let me know, and keep crafting, and I hope I'll see you soon again. Thank you and take care. Bye.